As health officials investigate the sewage spills, a study done by the University of Hawaii may make you think twice about entering the water and playing in the sand. Brent Ramadna spoke to researchers and joins us now with more. Brent?
Well, Joe, the good news is researchers tell me the study does not apply to every beach, only beaches where ocean water has been contaminated, like what happened at Ala Moana Beach Park earlier this week. Dr. Tao Yan led the study. He says oftentimes when both sand and water were tested after contamination, the sand would have 10 to 100 times more fecal matter than the water. While ocean water kills the bacteria, Dr. Yan says it can live longer in the sand. He hopes his research will make it a priority to test sand after major beach contaminations.
Really, you know, at this moment, I guess a good take-home message for everybody is that if you see the water is contaminated, don't assume the sand is better. You know, oftentimes if you go to the beach, when the beach is closed, the people just keep playing in the sand, which might not be a good idea.
Dr. Yan says the sand can be transported by wind, the tide, and people who have been in contact with it. And Dr. Yan says the sun can kill bacteria on the surface of the sand, but the bacteria underneath can live for days. Brent Romadna, KHON 2 News.